Good morning. You're watching Today in Parliament with me, Ashpura Kapoor, and here are the Parliament headlines. External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar to make a statement regarding developments in the Kulbhushan Jadhav case in both houses of Parliament. Key bills listed in today's business in Rajya Sabha, New Delhi International Arbitration Centre Bill 2019 and Arbitration and Conciliation Amendment Bill 2019 listed for consideration and passing. POCSO Amendment Bill 2019 to be introduced. And Lok Sabha to discuss Finance Bill 2019, a bill to be moved by Union Minister Nirmala Sitharaman for consideration and passing. External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar will make a statement regarding developments in the Kulbhushan Jadhav case in both houses of Parliament today. And now a look at the legislative business first in Rajya Sabha. Well, the Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Amendment Bill 2019 or the POCSO Act will be introduced in the House. The bill aims to amend the Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act 2012. The POCSO Act deals with crimes against children and includes death penalty for sexual assault on minors. Amendments in the POCSO Act also provides for fines and the imprisonment to curb child pornography. And Union Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad will move the New Delhi International Arbitration Centre Bill 2019 for consideration and passing. The bill provides to establish an autonomous and independent institution for better management of arbitration in our country. It also aims to establish the New Delhi International Arbitration Centre or the NDIAC to conduct arbitration, mediation and conciliation proceedings. It also declares the NDIAC as an institution of national importance. And Prasad will also move the Arbitration and Conciliation Amendment Bill 2019 for consideration and passing, which seeks to amend the Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996. It also aims to establish an independent body called the Arbitration Council of India for the promotion of arbitration, mediation, conciliation, and other alternative dispute redressal mechanisms. All right, let's go across to our colleague Kriti Mishra, who's joining us live from Parliament. Kriti, Parliament, you know, is witnessing its most productive session in 20 years. In fact, they have in reports that the government is also contemplating to extend the sittings for a few more days. How do you look at the day's business in Rajya Sabha today?
Well, Ashwara, the most important one being today, of course, the developments at the International Court of Justice. Remember, this has been a stupendous victory for India. The kind of diplomatic pressure it put on Pakistan and the kind of legal team and the redoubtable defense that it had put. We have come out victorious at the International Court of Justice in the Kulbhushan Jadhav case. And that is the most important statement. A sumo statement would be made by External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar in both houses of Parliament today. So it is expected in the Rajya Sabha that he'll make a statement at around 11 a.m. and in the Lok Sabha he'll make the statement at 12 noon. So very important statement coming there from External Affairs Minister. There are other important bills lined up in the Rajya Sabha as well. The POCSO Amendment Bill would be introduced in the Rajya Sabha. There are other important bills like the New Delhi International Arbitration Centre Bill for Mechanism for Institutional Arbitration and also the Conciliation Amendment Bill will also be placed in the Rajya Sabha today for consideration and passage. So important bills lined up in the upper house today.
Right, Kriti, stay with us. So we'll just come back to you. And the Lok Sabha on Wednesday passed the Appropriation Number 2 Bill 2019. The bill moved by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman was passed by a voice vote after the House approved the demands for grants for several ministries, which were collectively put to vote and passed by applying guillotine. Now, the bill allows the Union Government to withdraw 98.18 lakh crore rupees from the Consolidated Fund of India to meet its expenditure during 2019-20. And today, Union Minister Nirmala Sitharaman will move the Finance Bill 2019 for consideration and passing. This bill contains the tax proposals of the government for this fiscal. The budgetary exercise for 2019-20 will be completed with the passage of the Finance Bill by Parliament. Let's go back to Kriti. Kriti, as far as Lok Sabha is concerned, yesterday it cleared the appropriation bill and today Union Minister Nirmala Sitharaman will move the finance bill 2019 for consideration and passing. How does the day likely look like in Lok Sabha?
That's right, Aishwarya. So yesterday, the Lok Sabha cleared the appropriation number 2 bill as well as voted for several demands for grants of the ministries applying the guillotine process. And of course, today, Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman will move the finance bill containing the taxation proposals of the government, the revenue of the government, the expenditure of the government and the borrowing. So finance bill would be also discussed threadbare in the lower house, and thereafter it will be presented in the Rajya Sabha, and then the entire budgetary exercise would be complete. So important finance bill would be taken up in the lower house today. Aishwarya?
Thank you, Kruti, for all those updates there from Parliament. And now a look at some of the ministers who will be laying papers on the table concerning their ministries in the Rajya Sabha today. Ravi Shankar Prasad for the Ministry of Law and Justice and the Ministry of Communications. Smriti Zubin Irani for the Ministry of Textiles. Jitendra Singh for the Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions, Ministry of Development of Northeastern Region, and the Department of Atomic Energy. Dhotre Sanjay Sham Rao for the Ministry of Human Resource Development and the Ministry of Communications. V. Muralidharan for the Ministry of External Affairs. And Jitendra Singh will also make a statement regarding status of implementation of the recommendations contained in the 218th report of the Parliamentary Standing Committee on Home Affairs on the action taken by the government on the recommendations contained in the 210th report of the Committee on Demands for Grants pertaining to the development of the Northeastern Region. And here is a look at the ministers who will be laying papers on the table in the Lok Sabha pertaining to their ministries. R.K. Singh for the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy and Ministry of Power. Hardeep Singh Puri for the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Mansukh Mandavia for the Ministry of Shipping. And Pratap Chandra Sarangi for the Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. That's it in this edition of Today in Parliament. Do stay tuned. The proceedings of the Upper House are going to begin at 11 a.m. Thanks for watching.